Today I'm going to take you through some simple steps on how to create great URLs. Optimizing URLs for SEO means formatting them with your users and search engines in mind. A URL, or a uniform resource locator, most commonly refers to a web address directing to a web page. And of the three components, the protocol, the domain, and the web page, we'll be focusing on how to optimize the specific web page. Here are a couple of places you'll see URLs: the search engine results page and on the browser address bar. The first thing you'll want to do is set them right from the beginning. Avoiding making changes to your URLs means users can rely on their links and bookmarks, and search engines can rely on your content. Try to keep them brief. You can see here that we have two URLs. The top one is nice and short, and the second one below has been truncated, indicated by the three dots. Generally, 3 to 6 words is a good length for URLs, and you'll fit somewhere between 65 and 70 characters before Google truncates them. Short, eye-catching URLs make it more obvious to the person looking at it where they're going to go when they click, and when they share it on social or a forum, it'll be neat and clear. If you're running a blog, chances are you're using a CMS like WordPress. WordPress automatically adds a post's headline to the URL. It's a handy default feature, but you may want to think about editing them before you publish. You will also want to check out your permalink settings. If you're self-hosting with WordPress.org, you can manage how the CMS formats your URLs through the permalink settings. You can see in this article we recently published on our blog, we've cleaned up the URL so it's clear and relevant, and someone looking at it from the search engine results page will have a clear idea of where they will go when they click. Sprinkling a dab of keywords into your URLs makes them relevant to searches, but the main thing here is not to overdo it. In this example, you can see that for my search term knit a beanie, I found a result from Instructables, which has my search term in bold in the URL and the description. This wasn't at the very top of the results page, but it drew my attention because of the match. Keywords in URLs aren't going to directly affect your rankings, but you may see an impact indirectly as a result of your click-through rate. To help users and search engines better understand your themes and topics, you'll want to structure your site content in a logical way, which is then reflected in the URL. Zen Optimizer's training pages work in a similar fashion to how you might expect navigational breadcrumbs to work. Visitors to their site can intuitively go up and down the website's hierarchy. In this example, if you delete the intermediate part, you'll be taken back to the parent SEO page. And if you delete the SEO part, you'll be taken to the training root page, which is the parent to the SEO page. This site structure makes it easier for both search engines and users to predict what the underlying meaning of a page is, and to see how similar pages relate to each other. Sticking to conventions is pretty straightforward, and a lot of CMSs will use these by default. You'll want to use dashes, not underscores, stick to lowercase characters, edit out those gap words, and make sure you're using words rather than long complicated ID numbers. In an ideal world, we want our URLs to be sustainable and last a long time. If you do want to change them, you want to make sure you have a 301 redirect in place. Search engines build trust through URLs, and that's something you don't want to lose. So it's best to change them infrequently and only plan redirects as a necessity so that the reputation of your web pages will be maintained. That's it for today. You can check out the WordTracker blog for more advice and to read the original article this video is based on. You'll also find more technical advice on our academy. I'll include the links in the description below. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe for more SEO tips from WordTracker.